A really alarming study which found that black women are exposed to higher levels of toxic chemicals in hair products, and many of the potentially dangerous chemicals were not even listed on the labels. That's according to researchers who looked at 18 different hair products, things that like anti-frizz serums, leave-in conditioners, even hair relaxers. They found that 72% of the tested products contained harmful chemicals that could interfere with hormones like estrogen, which could lead to hormone-related issues in women. Marissa Chan with Black Women for Wellness and Environmental Research and Policy Manager joins me. And we were talking in the break because I sort of said, wait, is this widely known? Do we know this? And you were saying this is the first study of its kind that brought this kind of result.
Yeah, this is actually the first study of its kind that looked into specifically the concentrations of endocrine disruptors in hair products marketed to black women. And for those who don't know, endocrine disruptors, they are chemicals that are known to mimic their body's natural hormones, and they can do that, yeah, through several different processes, but they can block, mimic, as well as affect your body's hormonal system.
We know that black women have disproportionately suffered from hormone-related health problems, mm-hmm. like fibroids. Yeah. I've never understood why so many black women have fibroids, but I don't recall meeting anyone, a woman that wasn't black, that suffered from that.
Yeah.
So they correlated the use of the products with these chemicals and these problems in women.
Specifically, yeah. Certain chemicals, like I mentioned, endocrine disruptors, they can impact your body's natural systems, and so endocrine disruptors are being found to be connected to a whole range of hormone-related diseases and disorders. So connecting
to
fibroids.
Wait, isn't the FDA supposed to be looking?
That's a very good point.
So what? Did they fall asleep on the job, or are they not really aware of black hair products?
The FDA is aware of the chemicals that are in products, but they actually don't have the power to regulate, so there's no pre-market safety testing required. So companies can actually put almost any ingredient in a product and put it on our shelves.
So the onus is on the consumer to be informed, for the, not even just the consumer, but also stylists who are advising their clients to use some of these products, correct?
It should not be that way. It should not be on consumers to shop their way through products. It should not be on moms who have a bunch of different other issues in their lives, yeah, to be chemists, to be able to turn over a product and understand the ingredient label. But unfortunately, with our current regulatory system, it's on consumers, but it should not be that way.
Okay, so what do you want people at home to know?
I want people at home to know that black women are the most overexposed and underprotected to toxic chemicals in personal care products, and specifically black hairstylists are some of the largest impacted. And so Black Women for Wellness, we have a healthy hair initiative which focuses on educating and empowering black women, and specifically black hairstylists, with the tools to make changes in their lives. But I also want people to know that this issue is not just connected to regulation. Mm-hmm. Another side to this issue is the fact that black women are shamed for using certain products such as relaxers in their hair, but that really fails to connect it all to the fact that black hair is political. Mm. And the fact that black women are put in positions through like schools and education where they feel the need to straighten their hair. And that highlights the issue of Eurocentric ideals of beauty and how black hair isn't accepted.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and so there's two sides to this issue.
Ironically, you're here on a day where I'm wearing my hair straight, and I have worn my hair natural for years, much to the chagrin of many people, but it's who I am. Mm-hmm. I feel like we could talk about this more. I want you to come back because I think this is worth delving into, and
I would love
want to point people to what they can do also. There's an app called, mm-hmm, Detox Me, and if you download that app, it'll give you an idea of some of the ingredients that you can avoid, and it's something that your organization supports as well.
Yeah, we do support it.
Thank you so much for being here, Marissa.
Thank you so
I appreciate
much for
it. Really appreciate it. Worthy conversation to be sure.